I have been known to use the phrase spray and pray when shots haven't been going too well or due to my poor planning. However, does the phrase spray and pray make you a bad photographer or videographer as far as that goes? I'm Jaeger from YeagerShots.com. Welcome back here. This is going to be one of those videos with not a lot of cuts and B-roll. This is kind of how I do the podcast, but I thought it was such a nice topic to bring up. I would throw the camera on and talk about spray and pray right here. What brought all this up was a Facebook group. I've got the Shot Caller Facebook group. Get your info submitted to join, and I will most likely definitely let you in if you are all about learning a thing or two about photo and video. But I'm also in several other groups on Facebook, one of those being the Beginner Photography Podcast, which I have zero affiliation to. I just think they do really good stuff over there. And a beginner photographer just recently came up with the question of, is spray and pray bad because this is the only way I'm getting these shots done? And you can probably already tell where my answer is gonna go to this. I was more than happy, it's an open platform as far as the group, to respond to that. And my response was very, very simple. It depends on the project. For me, in video, spray and pray doesn't really work too well. I need to kind of have a bit of an idea of what it is we're trying to accomplish, what's the story we're trying to tell, what's the intent, and what's the context of everything. However, there's situations like for sporting events where you've got to fire off a couple of shots to get the shot. And I'll argue, yeah, you can anticipate what might happen on the court, on the field, if it's a car going in a circle, you kind of can guess how that's going to go. But I, as a portrait photographer, do quite a few photos of the old toddlers, and some of the kids just ain't taking no direction whatsoever. And you have no recourse but to spray and pray and get some shots and capture them in the moment, which kind of opens up how you get those awesome documentary style shots. So it's really not a negative to me at all. So the answer, does spray and pray make you a bad photographer? Only spray and praying at the wrong time seems to be the answer to that. If it gets the shot, then I think you're pretty good at photography. Swing by YeagerShots.com to get yourself some channel, photo, and video themed apparel. New shirts are indeed on the way. So keep checking in over there and subscribe. Hit that like button for those bell notifications, and you can even hit thumbs down. I think that helps with the algorithm too. It counts as engagement. That's what YouTube used to say. I don't know. But subscribe to never miss a shot from YeagerShots.com.